Seeing is believing. Yes? Seeing is believing.
Thank you, Ron.
It's on. Maybe you didn't hear it. Seeing is believing. Is that true? See, okay, so seeing is believing. I'm sorry, it's because I'm facing the speakers. Jesus Christ was born in Bethlehem. John says in chapter 1, verse 14, the Word became flesh. See? If I show you this, is it believing?
No.
Do you believe because of this? Because you've not seen? No. This is just a piece of glass that has a baby laying in a trough, see, underneath it. Now you've seen. Seeing is believing. Remember the Apostle Thomas, what he said? I won't believe that Jesus has risen from the tomb until... feedback. You're going to get me with a loud voice. Is that okay?
Yeah.
The Apostle Thomas said, I will not believe that he is risen from the tomb until I put my fingers in the nail holes and in his side. Then I will believe that Jesus is risen from the tomb. The scripture says today that he came to his own and they didn't know him. The Word became flesh, became the light of the world, and yet the world didn't recognize the light. He came to his own people in Israel, and they didn't know it was him. People tell me this Christmas, as I've heard many, many times in 37 years of ministry, oh, if Christ were to come today, I would know him. The Word became flesh and dwelt among us. And yet the world didn't recognize Jesus was here. So seeing isn't believing. Touching isn't believing. And yet this Christmas is all about the Word becoming flesh. Because if the Word, the creative Word of God through His Son Jesus Christ, did not become flesh, then Santa Claus reigns this Christmas. Amen? Then Christ isn't real. The Word didn't become flesh. Santa Claus is flesh and blood. Just go to any mall and you can see and touch Santa Claus. Jesus Christ this Christmas is a different thing, huh? And yet John tells us in that 14th verse, the Word became flesh and dwelt among us. And I'm going to throw you another spin now. I'm going to modify that 14th verse of John. The Word became flesh and dwells among us. Still dwells among us. Is still with us this day. Is still with us this Christmas. And it isn't in the packages, it isn't in the post, it isn't in the Christmas trees, it isn't in the fun that we have with our children this Christmas, and yet Christ is here. Christ is among us. The Word became flesh and still dwells with us. How do I know that? How do I know that the Word became flesh and dwells among us still? I know because of what the Christ has done in me. Oh, what person would I be had I not met the Word that became flesh? If I had not encountered Jesus Christ in this life, you who walk with Christ every day, you know the difference that Christ has made, yes? You can feel the difference that Christ has made in our hearts, in our lives, in our motivations, in the things that we will do, and in the things that we will say. You cannot be a follower of Christ and be the same old person. Amen? I tell the story, some of you have heard it before, some of you haven't, so I'm going to repeat it. There was once a saloon right across the street from a Methodist church. Right across the street from a Methodist church. And it had a talking parrot. One day that saloon caught on fire. And that parrot just got out with his life. He only had enough strength to land in the belfry of the Methodist church. Okay? Turns out it was a Saturday night when the bar burned down. And lungs full of smoke and feathers singed, the parrot passed out there in the belfry of the church. The next morning, the bells went off in that belfry. And it shook that parrot awake, and he was dazed, and he was still coughing up smoke and covered with soot. He looked down into the sanctuary of that Methodist church that had gathered for Christmas worship. And he looked behind the pulpit and he said, "We have a new bartender." And he looked into the choir and he said, "The showgirls have all changed too." And he looked out at the congregation and said, "Thank God it's the same old customers." If we walk with Christ, if Christ has been made flesh in us, we are not the same old customers. Amen? We are changed by the living presence of the Christ that goes with us and in us and changes our hearts, changes our motivations, makes us a different people. And Scripture says, for those who believed, he gave them the power to become the children of God. And there's a difference between the children of God and the same old customers, yes? We are not the same old customers. We are brothers and sisters with Christ. With Christ. We're part of God's family. So I know that the Word became flesh by what Christ has done in me. I also know that the Word became flesh through what Christ is doing with me in this life. You see, you can't be a follower of Christ and not do something. You can't be a child of God and not serve God. Our good deeds, our acts of service, the outreach that we do in the name of our heavenly parent, witnesses to the world that the Word became flesh and dwells among us. You want to see? You want to touch the flesh that became a part of our world? Here it is. I can feel, I can touch my brother in Christ. If Christ is living in him, if Christ is working through him, I see the flesh of God. I touch the flesh of God. It's real in each one of us. There's the flesh, right there. There's the Word that became flesh. There's the Word that became flesh. You see, when we do our good deeds because grace has motivated us, then we witness the blood and the body of Jesus Christ in the world in which we live. We become the Christ in this world, which is not to say we're divine. It's just that John said that the light which illumined everyone was coming into the world. Isaiah said the people who lived in darkness have seen a great light. And Jesus says, you are the light of the world. You're like a town that's been set up on a hill that can't be hidden. Amen? Jesus says he was the light of the world. And then he turns around and says, you are the light of the world. You are the flesh. You are the Word that became flesh. When you live out the life of Christ in your words and in your deeds. Does that seem right? Shh. Did the Word become flesh? Shh. Do I need to see it? Do I need to touch it? No. I don't. I feel the change. I feel the difference that Christ has made within me. I see who I was and who I've become since I became a follower of Christ. And I see what Christ is doing through me, what Christ is bidding me to do, which is to go out and to serve the realm of God. Let us be this Christmas the Word that became flesh. Let Christ be born in each of our hearts again, so that we feel that renewing and reconciliation that Christ works in each one of us. So that we might go out, and be the Word that became flesh in this world in concrete deeds, in concrete service, that elevates all of our brothers and all of our sisters in this world. Let us be Christmas every single day of the year. In Jesus' name, amen.